Hello everyone. So first of all, thanks for joining me today. So in the next couple of minutes, we would be talking about a tool that we at Nautilus have fabricated, that is Premonar, and we'll discuss that how it is a reactive platform to monitor our reactive applications. So, I am Sahil, and I am currently working with Nautilus Incorporated as a senior DevOps consultant. And so let's start and see what all this Premonar stuff is all about and how we are trying to, you know, based on all the learnings of reactive applications, how we are trying to fabricate a monitoring tool that is proficient enough to monitor efficiently our reactive applications. So this would be the agenda for today. So first of all, we would be talking about the monitoring needs of the hour, that what needs to be changed about monitoring or what needs to be improved in monitoring. Then would be what is reactive monitoring. Then we'll discuss the reactive monitoring challenges that needs to be taken care of. And then we'll discuss about Premonar, which would be a solution to efficiently take care and monitor your reactive applications, and followed by a swift demonstration depending on the time left. So just to understand what's the need of the monitoring, we'll just have a look at some of these thoughts. They say that traditional matrices of CPU and memory doesn't solve the purpose. So they don't provide any business advantage to our customers. So the monitoring should be done in a way that it gives an edge to the customer instead of just being satisfied that, okay, we are doing monitoring. Okay. Then is no matter how careful or good you are, shit will always happen. Then if it is not monitored efficiently, it isn't production. Then the next thought, talks about the roles and responsibility of the DevOps and how he should simplify the process of monitoring and efficiently capturing all the wrongs, all the things that could go wrong. Then is I think this is one of the most appropriate thought that we all face. So applications are up, monitoring is all applied, alerting is all set. Now relax until your systems go down and then go back and correct the things. So now let's talk a bit about reactive monitoring. So first of all, to understand about what reactive monitoring means, we first need to understand what actually reactive applications are. So reactive applications are nothing, just the basic applications which follow the reactive manifesto. So reactive manifesto is just a simple term which says that your application must be responsive, elastic, resilient, and message-driven. Responsive in a way that no matter how much scale you do to your, how much traffic is coming to your application, it should always give you a response. Then elasticity means it should be stretchable. You can scale it when the traffic is high and scale it down whenever the traffic is low. And then is resilience. Resilience means the way your application behaves when something goes wrong. And then is message driven, just to ensure that what all information is being transferred between your microservices and all is safe and secure. So this is what a reactive application is. So now the question is, the monitoring that we are using currently to monitor these such kind of systems, is it sufficient enough to monitor your reactive fleet? So let's see some of the challenges that are faced in reactive monitoring. By reactive monitoring, it's like all those systems which are dealing with reactive applications, like let's say Akka or Play or Lagom applications. So let's see what are general challenges with such applications. So the first challenge is moving and decentralized components. So this simply means that, okay, so for example, I say I have to monitor my application. So for that, I'll be using, let's say, Prometheus for matrices, then Splunk or Elasticsearch for capturing my logs. And in such a way, there would be a lot of components that are involved into my system, thus making the, you know, overall management of system a bit complex. And then is insufficient unmanaged alerting rules. So generally, after applying all these matrices and creating those dashboards, the next important thing is to have intact in-place alerting rules, and preferably if these alerting rules are being, you know, as per the company standards, are being provided by the fabricator of that particular tool as well. So just as to you know, have certain company standards for monitoring. And then the third thing is alerting of the mishaps after they have occurred. Okay, so now I have applied alerts, but when they go functional, when these alerts triggers, when something has gone wrong, my application has started yielding error responses, or my application has started, let's say, is no longer connecting to database. So the things have gone wrong, and then we are getting the alerts. Then is keeping up with evolving applications and tools. That means like simply the upgrades, the version upgrades and everything that we get in our existing infrastructure. Then is lack of visibility across the enterprise. So this is, I'll just share a common scenario here. So with one of my client, while I was working in a project, we were struggling. So sometimes the scope of and the volume of your project is so large that you don't even know what all components or tools and technologies your team actually has. So we were struggling with monitoring, and in some time we realized that there was already a tool that was a licensed purchase tool that was applicable to the team. So that means that there is a lack of visibility across the enterprise over the availability of tools and technologies. Then there's a lack of democracy in monitoring due to cost of acquiring commercial tools. So these are a lot of licenses that you have to manage, a lot of work that needs to be done. Lack of persistence of custom visualizations and alerts. So this is one very important point. So suppose I use any of the monitoring tool, I create my custom visualizations, dashboards, my alerting rules, but now what about persisting them? So let's say my Prometheus, or let's say any particular monitoring tool goes down. So how I recover all those hard work that I have already done, and will it be lost, or there would be a mechanism to recover it back? So generally that mechanism lacks. And so once your, let's say any of the monitoring tool goes down, along with it, all your alerting rules, visualizations, everything is gone. Then is dedicated environment-based classification of visualizations and dashboard. Another challenge is to, let's say you want to incorporate a single dashboard, and it should be fabricated in a way that it shows beta or staging environment one place and production one place. So managing all those things is a, you know, kind of a bit tricky part. So after seeing all these challenges and seeing that something must be done to address those, so at Noldus, we started working on a tool that is called Premonar, which is premonition-based monitoring and alerting platform. So by its very definition, it means it works on the premonition. So before any mishap has occurred, it proactively kinds of tries to alert that something might go down. Okay. So as I said, with years of experience in reactive stack, Noldus compiles all its learnings into a single tool, which we have named as Premonar. And this particular tool is based on three major driving factors. First one is monitoring of the reactive applications. Then is the monitoring platform must itself be reactive. Then is containing the mishaps before they turn into reality. So these are the three basic principles on which Premonar is based upon. Now let's talk about some of the features that Premonar provides us. So first of all is based on a reactive monitoring pipeline. That means we try to make sure that all the components, let's say, and yes, since it's an agent-based solution, so all the agents or all the server to which they are reporting are HA, and they are always available. And in case of a failure, there is a fail-safe mechanism that the agent is either respawned or is being brought back into action. Then is centralized insight of your distributed platform. It means, let's say I have an enterprise project where I make use of components like Kafka, Cassandra, Lagom, Elasticsearch, and all. So I need a single tool. It's basically a single tool which will compile all the matrices and provide every see-through of your system in a single platform, in a single distributed platform. Yeah. Customize as your, as per your appetite. So this with Premonar we ship like some of the dashboards and visualizations are and alerting rules are being provided on its own, and apart from that we can build our custom visualizations and all efficiently. Then is real-time monitoring and premonition-based alerting. So by real-time monitoring, it's simplistic. Like let's take an example of Kafka. So let's say I had two topics initially. Then I my data rolled in, and I created a couple of more topics. So instantly, that changes and all would be reflected on your visualizations. Then is a highly available monitoring platform. By highly available, it means it just satisfy the first basic principle of Reactive Manifesto that it should be always highly available. Then is one subscription, all solution. So yeah. Then is pre-built fleet of dashboard and alerting rule as per the project stack. So as per the technologies that are being used, by technologies we like, as I said, we generally focus technologies like Spring Boot, Lagom, Akka HTTP, Play, etc., and Elasticsearch, dgraph, you name it, Kafka, and all. So for that, a pre-built fleet of dashboard and alerting rules as per industry standards. So for example, in a certain application, I must always keep my heap size to be a minimum of this. And if its availability goes below it, let's say 80% or something, it should proactively alert me on that. And then is specialized for distributed environment like Kubernetes and DCOS. So since reactive components are generally microservice based, and to orchestrate those microservices, we use generally use Kubernetes or DCOS. So that was also one key point that was being taken care of while fabricating this. Now let us take a brief overview about the architecture of Premonar. So it's a simplistic, in simplistic terms, so we basically focus on the collection of two components, that is matrices and logs. So matrices are basically system matrices that is deals with like CPU and all stuff, memory occupied and all. Then is infrastructure matrices, like matrices related to your bare metal or AWS cloud and all. And then is application agents and APM and all to take account of the application performance matrices. So there is a component called extractor. So extractor just extracts the matrices which are being made available to it. Then, so for logs, we have a collector. So it's just, let's say your application is generating or your system is generating a couple of logs. So this collector just collects those logs in a single place and then ships it to your transformer. So transformer is nothing, it's just a basic or kind of a rule engine. What it does is it applies, so let's say you inserted data logs for all of your microservices running on Kubernetes. So Transformer in that case would be segregating the logs on basis of the app, on basis of the application, and on that basis it would apply certain transformations. So transformations can also deal with basically like transforming of matrices as well. So for example, the matrices converted were in micro cores of CPU, and I wanted it in terms of like normal cores. So all such kind of transformations are being taken care by transformer engine. Then is the data backend. So data backend is the place where the actual data, so we collect and transform it using transformer, is being stored. And on basis of this particular data, we have visualizer and alerter. So all the data which is persisted into data backend is being visualized using all those dashboards and visualizations. And the alerter here is the one which is responsible for generating alerts for like any of the wrong that is about to happen. Then the most interesting thing here is the premonition analysis engine. So in previous slide I mentioned that it senses that something might go wrong, and based on that it detects the anomaly, and based on that, so this is basically a machine ML engine that we have incorporated with our data backend. So it constantly poll and studies the data patterns that are being stored into backend, and on basis of that patterns, it proactively tries to determine that, okay, since my system is now moving to this particular state, there might be a chance that this error might occur. So that is the part where it, proactively or on basis of the premonition, it tries to determine that something might go wrong with the running components of my infrastructure. And all that data, that analysis data, that ML applied data is being stored back into the data backend, which is then used by alerters to, proactively kind of alert that something might go wrong. So we kind of basically categorize our alerts into two categories. One are the premonition alerts, which says that the things have not got wrong yet, but there might be a chance that something might go wrong. And another set is the normal plain vanilla alerter, which triggers when something has actually gone wrong. And yes, our alerter could be like integrated with PagerDuty, email, and Slack as well, so as to like have a wide array of alerting platforms. So let's take a look at what all things I can monitor using Premonar. So as I said, the monitoring for us is majorly classified into two particular categories. So application monitoring is nothing, it's just simple what all, like how my application, whether it be Lagom, Spring Boot, Akka, Play, and how it is behaving, and all the insights of that. So let's say the state of how many actors my application is using, and I'm like how it is performing, heap performance and all. And apart from that, so for certain components when we can't directly fetch matrices, what we generally do is we generate logs which can convey some information, and then using the transformer we convey that, we convert that log based text based data into metric data. So that's how we monitor all the applications in Premonar. And then another branch of the matrices are the infrastructure monitoring. So infrastructure monitoring is, so apart from the system monitoring, it's like, so for example, monitoring of Kafka, Cassandra, and dgraph, Elasticsearch. So basically it tells, okay, at a particular state in my Elasticsearch, how many shards are there, how many nodes are there in the cluster, and if something has gone wrong, apply alerts as per the scenario. And then similarly for Kafka, it's the matrices are like the current offset, and then the number of brokers and all. So these are the basic monitoring components that we try to capture. Now let's talk about some of the effect that Premonar induces. So first of all is it's automatically discover, configure, and customize all relevant metrics. Then is centralized monitoring and alerting tool for cluster health and log analysis. Visualize the health and topology of the distributed applications in real time. Then is high availability, persistence of dashboards and alerting rules. So as I said, so there is a provision that what all custom dashboards and visualizations and alerting rules that I build upon in my system, I can take its backup. And in case of any of the failures, I can directly restore those visualizations as it is. Thus, you know, eliminating that repetition of efforts that I may need to, you know, work on. Then is data science driven anomaly detection. Quickly detects and the tentative problems. So as I said, our ML engine, which is doing this job of having a premonition of something which may go wrong, so that you know ensures that you know system is you know in a better condition always. Then is clean and convenient setup procedure. So instead of having, you know, 10 agents or 10, let's say, exporters or anything, it's just a single agent, just a single pre-monitor agent that needs to be installed, and it takes care of everything. So this this particular agent can be installed over Kubernetes or bare metal. It works as it is. It just adapts the platform on which it's been installed. Then is clean and convenient setup procedure. I just covered that. Then is optimized threshold, ensuring real-time alerting. So yeah, that's with respect to the alert rules that comes packed in with it. Then is easily adaptable, customizable solution based on bulk. So by bulk, we means, so this tool underlying the major technology it uses are Beats, which is file beat, metric beat, and all. And then is Elasticsearch, Logstash, which works as our transformer, and then is Kibana, which works as our alerting as well as visualization platform. So let's start with some demonstration. Okay, so this is my demonstration architecture. So I have this Kubernetes cluster where I have one Lagom and one Akka HTTP application running, and along with that I have a Cassandra running over there, and I have a pre-monitor agent running over Kubernetes. Then on a bare metal I have one Elasticsearch to which my Akka HTTP application is communicating, and on that bare metal I have a pre-monitor agent, and same goes with Kibana, which is, you know, doing inter-service communication between Lagom and Akka. And then I have my pre-monitor engine running, you know, all like segregated to it. And then we can see all the visualizations and alerting that are being applied by it. Basically, these are the major namespaces. So in backend, I have, so in my backend, as I showed, there is my Akka application, my Cassandra cluster, 3-node Cassandra cluster, and my Lagom applications are running. And then I have a namespace called pre-monitor. So these are my pre-monitor agents. So this is basically, since it's a 3-node cluster for Premonar. So these are like agents running over the nodes, as well as there is one agent which is running on the cluster level and taking up all the matrices required. So well, I had like run my dummy applications for some time, and so this is the data that has been, you know, acquired by that application. And so basically these are the dashboards that we have created. So the only thing we needed to do here was start the Premonar agent, and all these like creation of these dashboards and all visualizations was being done automatically. So let's talk about Kafka. So in this particular visualization, it states what all topics are present in my Kafka cluster. So let's do one thing. Let's create a topic, and let's see, is it like picked up or not? I had set the interval to be 10 seconds right now. So as I created my topics, so the count of the topic was increased, and here I can see that what all topics I have. So since there is no data right now in it, so it would be all zero for this. So yeah. So let's take another example of monitoring of Kubernetes in itself. So as I said, so right now it's a three-node cluster that I have. So let's just I'll just run a Nginx image over it on the default namespace. Let's get back here and so my pods are increased by, and here I must see, yeah, Nginx Matsuri that has been started with a replication of one. So that's how, you know, reactively it, and once I delete it, so the deployment is 12, it should go back to 11. Yep. And okay. So this was with respect to it, and similarly we can view, you know, matrices which are related to your Akka based applications, like matrices related to your Akka actors and so. So this is a central dashboard to show all the components all the components that are part of your infrastructure. So for example, here I have three nodes that are the part of my Kubernetes cluster, and two, you know, as I showed, two bare metal nodes on which the applications are running. So it correctly shows that the number of systems that are a part of my total infrastructure are 5. And then if I want to, you know, see node specific metrics, I just get into that and I see that what is, the system matrices as well are being created all. So these are like all the most common matrices that we refer to, and obviously like it provides a wide array of matrices that are being collected, and all these matrices could be collected, and we can just create our custom dashboards using that. Similarly is for Cassandra, although I haven't done read-write operations for quite some time now, so it would be all plain. So yeah. So yeah, any questions, guys? Up till now?
Please come to the microphone.
Thank you, you were sharing. And I want to ask about how do you compare with this solution and other monitor solution like Prometheus? Thank you.
Okay, so that is a very valid question. Thank you. So one of the core thing which makes this Premona different is, as I said, you don't have to manage different monitoring tools for different platforms. So for example, whether it be my Kubernetes DCOS or just plain vanilla system, my bare metal system, in all scenarios it would be just this single agent that would be adaptable in all the scenarios. And another part is so for example, I'll take one example of, let's say we make extractors, we define extractors to collect matrices from certain tools. So for every kind of matrices to be collected, there is a extractor that needs to be run. So such a scenario is wiped out here. It's just one entity which is running and collecting everything. So as I showed, that agent, the same agent was running over the bare metal, which was running over the Kubernetes. And apart from that, the major importance here is the premonition analysis engine. So as I said that, so in ML they have a concept of states. So although this engine is won't be, in initial days won't be, work as expectations, but eventually when it will get all the states, it will collect all the data and convert into ML related information, eventually it will start drawing patterns. Let's consider a scenario. Let's say I see that my heap is constantly increasing, and there is, let's say, some back pressure coming on Kafka. So at that point, there might not be a way to generate an alert at that particular time. But when it will keeps on accumulating such kind of data and draw states, and that point of time it would be capable to detect that, okay, so in one place the back pressure is going wrong, in one place the heap is being accumulated, and if such a scenario is occurring, this could be the possible outcome of this. So such a scenario is also covered in this case. Sorry? The Scala, okay. So this is like purely, DevOps kind of component. So instead of being built upon Scala, it is, facilitates the application which are working on Scala. So let's say you are, as I discussed, the stack. So yeah. So basically all that microservice-based architecture and all, since as I said earlier that its prime focus is the orchestrator like Kubernetes. So all the microservices and the microservices running especially on Scala that the Noldus also deals with are being, monitored using this particular infrastructure. Okay, thank you guys.
Arigatou gozaimasu.
Thank you.